I am... Yeah, I am too. Hopefully this works out well, because we're probably going to see a lot of these two. Because basically, the only other one likely to get that far is Fail... Like, I'm guessing Failthos third, GoogleFrog second, Drone first. That's going to be my prediction.
Well, I guess I have to be the contrarian. I'll say GoogleFrog takes first, Drone takes second, and then, yeah, Failthos in third.
Well... Yeah, okay, so we agree on Failthos in third. I was mentioning to Sackdoth, it really comes down to how much GoogleFrog and Drone have been practicing relative to each other.
That's a very good point. I hadn't considered that. Do you know if GoogleFrog is in practice?
I haven't been playing too much recently. I've been kind of busy with combo breaker prep and also with just... I've been playing too much Dark Souls.
All right, no worries.
Yeah.
I haven't actually been playing too much either myself, but I guess we'll just have to see. This first game should shed some light on it for us.
Yeah, so it's... This should be interesting. So the winner's finals, which will be Drone GoogleFrog. The first map, I can't remember offhand. Oh, it's... Hide and Seek. No, it's... Wanderlust, I guess. Yeah. Okay.
Fun.
Yep, so GoogleFrog versus Drone on Wanderlust.
I'm a big fan.
Yeah, Wanderlust is a map I have been missing, honestly.
I hope we'll see some jump jets here.
Yeah, I mean... Yeah, I guess people don't really know how this map works anymore. It's like it's usually jump jet versus light vehicle or something along those lines.
Interesting.
So at this point, we are going to have... I said GoogleFrog and Drone. Not sure when they're going to actually start. What'd they go up to? Where's GoogleFrog and Drone? They're somewhere. Okay, I'm confused now. I don't know where people are going.
GoogleFrog's in the room with us.
Yeah.
Oh, so it's Drone.
Not sure why they're waiting. I mean, the loser's bracket isn't that far behind. As you can see by looking at it, it looks a little bit far behind, but then it's just... Like, basically, Aquanim Snuggle Base, and then whoever wins that, Failthos, and then whoever wins that, probably Steel Blue. But... That's fine, we'll get to it when we get to it. GoogleFrog and Drone's gonna take an hour anyway.
But no doubt. I'm sure you're right.
Oh, an old Ghost Stalker showed up. At some point. Eventually. Which is kind of funny, because they're in Italy. They should be in a good time zone.
Yeah, nice, convenient, sane part of the day.
Yeah, it's like 11, I think. Well, right now it's more like 4, but still. Alright, so we're going to be moving on once that gets going.
Oh, what's the progress on the loser's round? Taking the
well, Aquanim and Snugglebase are going, and then whoever wins that will be...
Trying to clear defenders, it looks like.
I don't think people seem to understand how parallelism works. Like, everyone plays their games whenever they can. Don't worry about me unless I... Okay, worry about me when I want to get into a game and watch it. But at this point, it doesn't really matter because we're at Winner's Finals, and Winner's Finals, Loser's Finals, Grand Finals has to go in that order. So I don't need to worry about saying, no, stop, don't play that match yet, because we're not doing single elim anymore. We're doing double elim, which is very nice. But yeah, at the rate it'll take for GoogleFrog and Drone to be done, we probably will have... By the time that's done... The losers pre-finals will have started, or just about to start. And we're starting now with this one. Yeah, Wanderlust. I have to go over that map. I haven't seen it in a while.
Yeah, you know, I've seen less and less of it lately. I really do enjoy it, though.
Yeah, it's one that I found... Oh, when I said... Did I say jump bots versus light vehicles? I thought you were talking about Quicksilver.
Oh.
Yeah, jump bots get used decently on this map, but not that often.
Yeah, unfortunately. Maybe spiders?
I haven't seen spiders used at all in a long time. Although, we're going to see it now, because drone's building exactly that.
Excellent, excellent. You know, I've been growing more and more fond of spiders recently. I feel like they've become more playable than maybe they were when I started. Or maybe I've just become less terrible at using them.
No, redbacks were made more playable.
Okay.
Yeah, I've always kind of messed around with spiders, and when redbacks were added, that was a huge change.
Mm-hmm.
Because it was like Morph was removed, and then they needed a better Riot than a Warrior. Because the best Riot that the Spider-Bot's best Riot was a Warrior.
Hmm.
Yeah, because Fleas would morph into Glaze would morph into Warriors. But now, yeah. But when Morph went, which was probably for the best, then the Spider-Bot needed something, and the Redback was added around the same time. Not sure if that was the exact reasoning, but Redback was necessary. So, good thing it was added. Anyway, Drone... Yeah. Just scouting out, see what's going on. Fleas cannot really raid too well, especially on this map. So I'm going to go over this briefly. So we have generally a couple viable stars points. Where GoogleFrog and Drone are starting is the common one. The other one is over in the lower pit area in the southwest and northeast. That area tends to be a bit more defensive. It's actually hard to defend, all things considered. But you often see newer players go to that, or players who are kind of trying to play a bit more of a closed-in strategy. But GoogleFrog and Drone both going for the slightly better defended, but feeling more open area to the north. Feels more open, but it's not.
Hmm. Like, it also has the advantage of easier access to the metal spots to the north and the south.
Oh, that's true. The southwest and northeast does have that. That is actually a pretty big deal. Because that ramp there is bot pathable. If we were to go to actually click on a bot. Yeah, there's a bot pathable section of that ramp. But yeah, all things considered, where GoogleFrog and Drone are, that's normally where you see players start up. And then from there, it's just you try to take the center because there's a lot of valuable mexes. But mostly to try to take your side and then try to take the north if you're the eastern player and the south if you're the western player. That's how the players play. That's how this game, that's how this match goes in this map.
Yep.
So if you can take your opponent's favored side and hold it, that's a big deal. And oftentimes you see players do that. Like, Drone already is kind of moving towards the north. GoogleFrog hasn't moved towards the south much, though. They're taking the southeast, so they're taking their side, but they're not taking the south center.
It looks like he's hanging there with his commander just now. I'm really surprised to see that Drone did plop spiders. It feels like it might put him in a box here, because I know that Rockos are so powerful against the Spiderbot factory, but maybe if Drone can make use of these cliffs here, or these sort of sharp edges, to make some ambush points. That might work out well for him. But it's just, Cloaky has so many good answers to Spider.
They do, but these cliffs are not bot pathable except for Spiders, so at least that does give the Spiders the ambush option. However, with Rockos, I found that Rockos don't actually counter the Spider Factory. They counter Venoms, and it used to be that Venoms were the Spider Factory, but with Redbacks and Hermits being considered more powerful now, or at least more often used, Rockos, they are a powerful unit, but they are not dominating the matchup. You need to worry about other units.
Snipers as well.
Snipers are actually really hard to use. They kind of force crabs to not move when the crabs get up. But basically, if the crabs are in place, if they are deployed, all the snipers are doing is giving away their position.
Okay, fair enough. I actually didn't even think about the crabs. But against a sort of mid-game spider composition, I usually just play Rocco, Sniper, and then a couple of Glaives to screen for Fleas.
Right.
It works out well for me, but I'm not playing against GoogleFrog, Drone, I mean.
Yeah, it was. The thing is, if a sniper came up, there would be 2 dozen Fleas just scouring every inch of the map just to try to get rid of that sniper. Spot out the sniper and kill it. And by the time that comes up, we probably would see crabs. It would be set up as a counter to crabs. That's typically how it works.
Yeah, I'm curious to see how GoogleFrog responds to this. Drone's definitely doing really well with the spiders. Not really having any issues with the Rockos.
Well, there's only one or two at this point, so it's not that big of a deal.
Sure.
There is one. The second is in production. But like I said, the redbacks don't have as big of a problem. The venoms do, but the redbacks tend to survive long enough. They can move in fast enough. I've never really had much success trying to kill redbacks using Roccos. It's always backfired. Mm. I thought I could, but no, it's weird. I'm actually not sure why. It doesn't really make sense, because Roccos are faster. They have a longer range. They just...
The spiders can juke pretty well.
That's true.
Get out of the way of the rockets. So you really need like a critical mass to saturate the area around them. So I there's sort of a breaking point, really.
Yeah, and I suppose Roccos, they deal 180 damage a shot, so it takes a few shots to kill... Although, on the other hand, it takes that many shots to kill a Venom, too, so I am not sure why it always seems to me like Redbacks have a really good time. But that's been my experience. Redbacks just are harder to counter with Roccos than Venoms are.
But I think we can both agree that Glaives are not the canonical answer to Venom Redback, right?
No, that's... The Venom Redback is the canonical answer to Glaives.
Right.
It's quite the opposite.
Yeah,
and
I'm
crabs,
really...
Oh, early crab.
Oh, there we go, yeah.
Drone on over Hermit game.
A really big reason to plop a spider factory is just to rush a crab. They can be very tricky to deal with in 1v1. In teams, you know, it's not such a big deal.
No, because usually someone has a bomber or two or five or two dozen.
Exactly, but in 1v1, it's definitely a menacing threat. Nice raid coming out here down to the south.
Yeah, that's going to not do too well, though. It's going to get rid of a few metal extractors, but then the lotuses will probably take care of the drone. Drone did their common solar bunch up on top of the lotuses.
Yes.
It's like four glaives are left trying to kill solar plants, not dealing a whole lot of damage, and drone now has about 500 reclaim to work with.
Yeah, I don't agree with diving into the LOTs like that. But that was beautiful. Yeah, I was thinking about this the other day, how he sort of clumped up his solars in strange positions. So the glaives are going to have to kink around them to get to the LLTs to even be able to
drone
fire at them.
Drone does this all the time.
It's beautiful.
Right. They just do this sort of thing. Whenever they're playing, it's just... If they have a position they can't necessarily well defend easily, they'll set up a bunch of mini choke points within the solar plants and then set lotuses inside them, because the glaives want to kill the lotuses because get rid of the damage. The players want to kill those. But trying to do so just puts them in this box. They get surrounded on all sides, and then drone just kills them. It's a very nice trap setup. It works remarkably well.
Seeing some Rocco spam from GoogleFrog here. unfortunately, I don't think they're going to do much against this crab. Just a bit too late, I think.
Maybe. I mean, the sharpshooters would be a great idea because it basically forces the crab to remain deployed.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, Roccos are actually fairly good against crab, all things considered. Oh, and Skazi pointing out that Venom is actually fast enough that Rocco may not be that good against it compared to other riots. I think it's just the health. Like, between the health and the speed, the Venoms still get countered by Roccos.
Hmm. But even when the Venom catches up, I mean, typically they hold still for a bit while they're EMPing their target, unless they're being micro, right? So it's still pretty easy for the rest of the Roccos to clean up. But again, that just depends on the critical mass. Airplane factory out for GoogleFrog with a Thunderbird up in the northeast, by the way.
Well, that's probably going to... I mean, GoogleFrog is in a really nice spot right now.
Ooh, but a second crab just came up for drone.
It did, but with that EMP in place, or the disarm in place, all they need to do is take out both crabs, and at that point, it's basically open.
Oh, are these Roccos sneaking down? Oh, look at this. Down to the south, these Roccos are sneaking through into this little pocket.
Yeah, but drone sees
it.
Drone sending they're sending the fleas in, and fleas counter Roccos handily.
Yes, definitely. They'll clean this right up. But still, I had no idea that that was even bot pathable.
Oh yeah, that ramp is totally bot pathable. Look at the F2 view. There's ramps on both that side and the north side. They're both bot pathable. It's very close. It's very nearly not bot pathable, but it totally is. But yeah, at this point, unfortunately, due to lack of glaives, those Roccos are going to have a hard time. Not an impossible time, though.
Glaives coming out now, but just a bit out of position. Oh boy, this commander's
out of position.
Trouble.
Yeah, the commander is probably got a retreat. I don't see any way out of this. But the Roccos have managed to deal with the fleas. GoogleFrog not paying much attention, though. Drone's commander is open, and Drone is actually behind economically, so that'd be an even bigger blow. There we go. There's the Thunderbird. That's what we're looking for.
Just in time, and now the glaives are rushing in behind it. Oh, this is beautiful.
Yeah, there's nothing stopping this.
I hope he'll clean these crabs up. This would be the most excellent play.
They're not going to. They need to kill the Venom first. That's Venom is the biggest threat.
You definitely bought himself some time. Oh!
Nice, as the crab was moving at the time, getting hit by its own ally projectile. But like I said, Venom was the biggest deal. That needed to be dealt with easily. And the Rocko's still alive. The Rocko's not actually going down to the fleas. And finally moving forward, Drones Commander getting under great threat. And we're another Thunderbird Strike.
Most of the crabs has gone down.
Yeah, one of them's gone down. The other one's irrelevant.
Forced retreat. Wow.
And Drones Commander is one shot away from death. There it goes. Drones Commander has now died. Goodbye, Drones Commander. And Drone throws in the towel. GoogleFrog taking game one.
What?
Okay.
That... What?
Okay, Kaen.
All right.
I will grant you that you probably have a point that GoogleFrog may have a bit of a chance here. Actually, their Elo values are so close that I'm probably being facetious by trying to assert anything else.
Sure, sure.
So it's probably anyone's game. Oh, and apparently Venom's actually faster than Rocko.
That makes sense.
So we were moving on to game two, and that was...
What a turnaround. I felt like Drone was in the better position, and I honestly didn't think GoogleFrog would have a great answer to the crab push, but as you pointed out, the disarm planes were just so effective there. I can't believe you did that.
Oh, I'm surprised they didn't do that sooner. But yeah, this is basically... Well, that's game one. We're moving on to Drone's favorite map. By far favorite map. I have worse. I have worse is Drone's absolute favorite. Like, this is the map that if Drone were to be given a choice of all the maps in the game, they'd pick this map.
Mm-hmm.
And they do a pretty good job of it, too. It's a very nice mix of micro and macro that just suits Drone perfectly. What?
Oh, well, GoogleFrog, of course, didn't choose Drone's favorite. He chose the other option, Titan Duel. Still a macro map, though.
Yeah, but it's not the same.
Apparently, Drone's second favorite, from the looks of things.
Yeah. Okay, never mind. We're on Titan Duel. My titles are incorrect. Here I'd gone all this effort to actually set up the titles, and I was wrong. So we are, in fact, on Titan Duel, not Eye of Horus. I was mistaken, because normally people don't change the map before it's too late. Actually, it looks like that happened automatically. No one actually set it to Eye of Horus, it just happened to be... The host did, I guess. Oh, no, never mind. No. Drone did. Never mind. Drone had done it a little while ago, and then didn't realize, oh, I need to give you choices. And then it's like, oh, right, yeah, here are my choices. Well, I'm not going to let you have Eye of Horus, that's for sure. Like, that's for darn sure. You're too good at that map. Titan Duel, which we have seen before. GoogleFrog having
my vehicle mirror. What do you think?
I don't know. With these players, I could see either of them going for...
I'm like 100% the drone's going to go LV. I think Google might go...
I don't know. I think it's 50-50 whether they go light vehicle or heavy tank.
Tanks, yeah. I'd like to see tanks too.
But let's see. No, GoogleFrog light vehicle. Light vehicle mirror. That's exactly what's happening.
Boring.
Hey, it was a pretty good light vehicle mirror with you and Aquanim.
Hopefully this one has less blunders.
Well, Drone plays a similar style to you with having very little defense and a lot of aggression. Well, actually, yours is more expansion than aggression, but still. Plays a low defense style. GoogleFrog plays a high slasher style. They're mobile defenders.
Hmm. It's good style, too. Yep, yeah. And that's what we're seeing here. Two right out the gate.
Well, that is two darts and two slashers. Well, GoogleFrog's clearly going to win that engagement if it comes up. So Drone basically just needs to avoid that engagement entirely if they can at all help it.
Mm-hmm.
And just spotting the commander too, seeing where it's being built up, not bad. Dart just sort of hanging out.
GoogleFrog's dart is trying to get tucked fire. In behind the solar here. Mostly just giving him the runaround. It gets taken out eventually.
Yeah, that's way too open enough to worry about it. There's no easy way to choke it out. And the dart getting killed by the slasher. No surprise there. Yeah, GoogleFrog will be just playing a slow crawl style, which basically I think it'll come down to whether or not Drone can win in the first 10 minutes.
Mm.
Like, if Drone gets the advantage in the first 10 minutes, I think GoogleFrog will have to try to well, win in game three. But if GoogleFrog manages to make this crawl work, which, I don't know, might be tricky. Drone's going to be pegging at these slashers, probably. It looks like they're setting up more darts for bait and more scorchers to actually kill them. They can successfully.
I mean, just a great incentive for Drone to build more and more scorchers, and plus you'll have a mobility advantage, too. So, I don't know, this is a pretty risky call from GoogleFrog. It's so weird to see him just keeping these slashers in the base, because typically you see people move out so early in 1v1, but, I mean, you're kind of forced to, just because of the way the slasher works.
Also the way this map works, because of the corner starts.
Right.
It's a lot trickier, because you don't have that, you don't have really the choke point set up, and especially with slashers, you don't have the body blocking option.
That's true, too.
And that's such an important option on this map. I mean, we didn't really see it too much this game, but there have been games where it's been a deciding factor. Where it's just, you just go up and down, it's like constantly going up and down, and the other person trying to wait until their opponent is not paying attention, and then go in the right position where their opponent isn't, and push in. But GoogleFrog has all the slashers, they're not undefended. So that's,
you know, by using sort of a low micro unit like a slasher, well, I guess they're sometimes low micro, it sort of frees them up to macro a bit more and keep up with Drone's certainly macro-oriented style.
Well, that's why I think GoogleFrog goes for it, for that very reason. There's no point focusing on that. They got more things to focus on. Focus on the slashers, or sorry, the scorchers going forward, but they essentially have mobile static defense.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's why they do it. I've asked them before about it, and that's essentially the reason. And Drone once again going for Particle Beam, stopping the Scorcher from getting anywhere near the rest of it. That was exactly what they needed to do. Because as we can see, Drone has no defenses.
Yeah. Yep. I felt like that Scorcher could have just dove in a bit closer, but that was a nice hold by Drone.
Yeah, it... I don't know. It might have been able to avoid it on a slightly wider angle, maybe, but it was hard. Yeah. It's not impossible to avoid that.
So Drone is building his own little troop of slashers. So this might turn into even more of a mirror match than we expected.
Yeah, but they're very forward with them. Like, they're being extremely aggressive. And that's on top of a bunch of other static defense, whereas GoogleFrog, they have yet to build any static defense. They're still relying entirely on slashers. Oh, never mind. Never mind. One Lotus. First static defense they've built all game. Lotus is at the edge of their territory. So it looks like they're playing like Drone, but Drone is being much more aggressive. They aren't using their slashers as GoogleFrog has been. However, GoogleFrog, wow, they need a lot more energy. That's the one thing. You look at their energy right now, like 23, 21. Oof. No, not what they need. They need 40, 30 or 40 in order to be able to deal with the reclaim, in order to be able to deal with the production. I mean, they're accessing metal, and that's not good.
It's pretty significantly behind in military value as well.
Well, that's the excess. That's the thing.
Yes.
That's 500. Like, half of the difference is currently in GoogleFrog storage.
Yes. Oh, boy. This is, I don't know. It's not looking very good for GoogleFrog, because at this point, Drone can just play GoogleFrog's game, and because he has the better eco, he'll win at it.
Yeah,
you can see here he's starting to mass these slashers more and more. He's tearing down this western position just bit by bit. He doesn't need to be taking damage with the slashers, but he is.
And GoogleFrog has... They have the economy, they don't have the build power. They're just now gaining the build power with this one last Mason.
Yeah, this is a stranglehold here. Slashers and Scorchers just pouring out of Drone's factory now.
Yeah, at this point, I think GoogleFrog can even it out. They just need one more Mason and use that. But they aren't building one right now. But if they built one more Mason and set it on the factory, they'd be able to push their storage through and probably even out the military advantage.
Yeah, that's a good point.
They have to win a few combats, but if they do that, they'll make it even.
Slipping further and further away. Well, I guess,
No, it totally is. Ooh, did not get rid of the Ravager. Two health? What the hell? Hero Ravager. Total Hero Ravager. And GoogleFrog's commander also in an iffy spot right now. Desperation defenders try to help get rid of that particular slasher, but... Will that work? One more missile, yes, that gets rid of the slasher at the cost of itself, but that it did its job.
You can see these Scorchers down at the south were lining up to try and cross these slashers here. See if they can dive in right now.
They're going to die.
Unfortunately
all
not.
All of them going to die. Two slasher kills, though.
They were lined up really well. Yeah, that's not bad at all. A third one?
That's not...
Okay.
Oh, wow, the slashes were... Wow, panics.
And they get pushed away. I mean, GoogleFrog has a Mason right here to take the reclaim, and slashers on the way to maybe take some control of it. Plus, there's definitely going to be a big fight down here.
Yeah, well, that was actually pretty good from GoogleFrog, getting rid of those slashes that Drone had. Like, Drone pulled them away when they really didn't need to.
Exactly, yeah, just pushing them away was a good win, and having a chance to contest this reclaim is potentially going to keep them in the game longer.
Although at the same time, Drone has Drone is no easy ways out. Their static defense.
Economy, yeah.
Their static defense alone, and GoogleFrog is still accessing metal. They only have 15 build power going into the factory. They have another Mason built up to get 20, and another one to get 25. But at this point, they could healthily go for 30, and they kind of need to. They've been working well in combat, so they're still... The army difference has not changed. The actual army values haven't really changed, which is exactly what GoogleFrog needs. But yeah, now they have 25 metal in the factory. Now they can push out. But at the same time, that's compared to Drone building a gunship plant with 25 of their own on top of another caretaker.
It looks like GoogleFrog's playing on Ravagers to break out. Wow, Drone's building his gunship factory already.
I mean, if they mass the Ravagers, that'll work okay. The slashers are dead, though. That's the only problem. GoogleFrog has none left.
And Drone is building his own Ravager ball to just sort of poke in here as well.
Yeah, so it's going to be a fight of the Ravager ball. Not much else is really around. One more Mason would probably do the trick. No, never mind, I can't do the trick. GoogleFrog is now at the edge of their economy. They do not have the economy to build up beyond that. I think Drone has this game.
I would say so as well. The GoogleFrog's commander up on the eastern side is just about to get dislodged from his position. I mean, these Ravagers are getting ready to poke in themselves. Drone just has a ton of build power right here on the reclaim field anyway, so this is all his, and he's already, you know, nearly doubled GoogleFrog's economy.
Yeah,
unfortunately,
no,
this does look like a lost game for GoogleFrog here.
Well, at least GoogleFrog won game one, so GoogleFrog can move on to game three and do okay.
That's right. Yes, that's right, and we'll see a three rounds, which is, I mean, I love... Love a good dramatic match.
Well, I did say this would probably take about an hour, so... I was not wrong!
That's right.
Alright, because yeah, as you can see, GoogleFrog is way... Like, corner? Rest of the map.
Yeah,
never
he's at
healthy
about
position.
Maybe 25% map control?
Not really even. I mean, there's the big... chunk in their main base where it's like they push through the front lines and that's it.
Yeah.
So it's a frail position and Drone. Like, they're focusing so much on defenses. If it's the military advantage and the economic advantage combined. Because the Ravagers would be able to push through this. But they can't without losing the position they need to keep Drone at bay.
As soon as they left, I mean, just some Raiders would swarm in here, really. This is such a fragile position for GoogleFrog. Even these two Ravagers, you know, might just tear it up. All they
I
need
think
to do
it's
is
gonna win the game.
Yeah, come through and pick off the next. I mean, we're really just waiting this out. GoogleFrog's trying as best he can to turn around, but I don't see much hope for him here.
No, not unless they manage to reclaim everything and build up like another 10 solar plants.
Yes.
And these Ravagers are tearing everything apart. Everything. The Wolverines aren't even doing much. It's just no. Another worker goes down. Yeah, GoogleFrog throws in the towel, and will now be able to choose a map favorable to them.
Well,
suggest maps favorable to them.
Sure. Awesome. Yeah, coming into this third game, I'm sure GoogleFrog's going to be really happy that he's picking the map. I know, heading into that third game with Aquanim, I was pretty bummed that he got to choose the map.
Yeah, so GoogleFrog... What would they pick? They might pick C.
C, yeah.
I was just going, but they might.
Something, I don't know, something twisty like that.
So yeah, GoogleFrog.
GoogleFrog says he doesn't know what happened.
Well, as far as I can tell, what happened was that GoogleFrog basically held back and then couldn't get the economy they needed. They didn't push out.
I think it was definitely that. I think the East all played a huge part, of course.
Yeah.
As we saw Drone start to pull away
East
early
all
on.
East production
the,
still.
Yeah, military lead. So, I mean, just probably the combination of those three things, that's more than enough to lose you a game at this level of play.
I'm just surprised there was East all that level. Like, it just yeah. never happens.
Me too, but it's also a little bit encouraging because I always have problems with E-stalling, so it's nice to see a skilled player do it too.
Because it happens to the best of us.
That's right.
So from here, it's going to be GoogleFrog's map choice. And I do think that GoogleFrog, given the way they were playing between this map and Wanderlust, that they really will want something like Tartarus might work pretty well, or if they want to risk it, Ravaged might work.
I think he's going to try and stay away from macro-y maps. I think GoogleFrog might have the advantage on a smaller, less sort of late game oriented map.
Yeah. I could see Tartarus working.
I would agree with Tartarus. That's sort of what I'm thinking. Something in that vein.
But. Yeah. Oh, I see. It looks like Drone basically realized Slasher was coming up, and it was basically defense, so Drone went expand. So Drone just did a strategy counter. That answers that question. Makes a lot of sense.
Beautiful. Yeah, that definitely explains the discrepancy in expansion.
So,
well,
are we going?
Nice. That was a beautiful read. Excellent strategy counter by Drone then.
Yeah. And that's the thing, is you've got to really be mindful of that sort of thing in this game.
Yeah,
more than
true.
Most.
Yep.
Well, it looks like it's... on to, well, like I said, game three. Where's... what maps? Yeah, Drones. Pick map! We need to get on with this.
GoogleFrog's still analyzing it.
Well, I can't say I blame them. Like, what map would you go for? Because Drone knows.
mm-hmm.
Drone knows what map they go for. But GoogleFrog, yeah. What map would you go for?
Yeah. I don't know. Tough call. God, it's like, do you go with something that you know that you're solid on? And try to play a straight map, or do you try to go for like a Hail Mary? Like something, just something weird.
I think try and catch them off guard. I think at this stage it's worth going for a Hail Mary. If GoogleFrog loses, worst case scenario, they have to fight whoever wins in the loser's round in order to get back in.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Whereas if they're in grand finals and try to go for a Hail Mary, like, they're in a much worse position.
Uh-huh.
To the point that I think they'd probably end up throwing it away if they weren't careful.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, all's not lost. Losing this game, you can still wind up in the grand finals. The suspense is killing me. Oh.
Intersection.
Ho-ho. So this, I don't know, it feels like it's along the same lines as Tartarus.
Crossing. Wow.
Intersection, it looks like it will be.
Why are they going to V2? It's V3. There we go, that's the latest one. So yeah, intersection V3. That's actually not super surprising, but I don't know if it's quite a shoo-in.
Definitely not a shoo-in.
Yeah, it's going to come down to what happens in the first 3 minutes of the game.
Hmm.
Like, after the first fight, I think we'll know.
Well, any guesses for the factory picks? My vehicle, I guess, is the conservative choice.
I honestly don't know. It's one of those maps that you see a pretty even spread of light vehicle, mm-hmm. Cloaky, and shield.
Yes. I like Cloaky. It's an interesting map to play like jump jets on. And obviously, the end game there is to jump up for the
through the sides,
the base run.
Although base runs in this map are just suicide half the time. A Cloaky versus light vehicle. Drone going for the light vehicles, right. And GoogleFrog with the Cloaky. GoogleFrog, both players going aggressive. No, GoogleFrog is going for scout. Never mind. GoogleFrog with the one scout. Scorcher to dart to Scorcher. Okay, drone being hyper aggressive. Two Scorchers, two darts before a builder. And yeah, GoogleFrog. Okay. Well, setting up a pretty safe setup. I mean, they have the strike commander. They have a position they can easily walk down and build more metal extractors. Drone, on the other hand, moving back. They're using an Econ Commander build range to basically build the entire base up before getting their Mason.
Hmm. Interesting. Yeah, that frees them up to build a lot of Raiders quickly.
But at the same time, GoogleFrog is up front. So their commander is up front. It's able to deal damage. It's able to build up Defender.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that GoogleFrog will be able to deal with this. And they have a Glaive coming in, but I think that Drone's commander will not have a problem. Although Drone, they are paying attention, I think. Yeah, they're paying attention.
It's level 0. It's going to be kind of squirrely to hit it with the shooter.
But,
there we go.
Oh, but the Glaive was way too close. It needed to go further back.
That's right.
Drone was not... Actually, GoogleFrog was not paying attention to that Glaive.
Mm-hmm.
And then another Scorcher coming in, but the Scorcher head-on match, that's not what you want to do. Not unless you're using Warriors or... Yeah, Warriors basically is all you have.
Yeah.
Not with Glaives. I wouldn't do that with Glaives.
So Drone's just sort of parking by these metal extractors at the bottom of these ramps. Not really heading into the base, which is, of course, suicide.
Well, yeah, because this map, I mean, you have your four in the center, you have the two in the bottom, and then you really want to get to these corners, and Drone's basically stopping GoogleFrog from going to the northeast or southwest corners.
It's a very early soft contain.
But it's extremely powerful. However, because GoogleFrog's Cloaky bot... Drone needs to be a bit more conscientious of what's going on. Like, they can't just block it. The workers,
that's right,
as you can see, walk past.
Exactly, yeah. GoogleFrog sneaking his constructor down the southern side.
So there is a dart on one of the metal extractors, but that's fine. I think that the constructor will go over to the far, far southwest metal extractor first.
Yes.
And then build down after defending a bit.
Agreed.
And as you can see, Drone not actually building there yet. Their commander moving slowly forward, but their masons... are not even poised to go there. They're actually setting up for the center. It's setting up for the lower section.
Mm.
So GoogleFrog in a more defensible region, but with the same power. So I think GoogleFrog is slightly ahead, but it's basically down to the first battle.
Yeah.
And once that battle happens, then we'll know who really has the advantage here. And it looks like it's going to go to GoogleFrog. Although it's hard to tell because GoogleFrog... Well, I have a few... Oh, no, that's free! That's open! You can take it! Ah, well, getting rid of Metal Extractor, but not getting rid of the Lotus, that is a waste of unit, unfortunately.
Fortunately, yep.
Waste of a lot of units. Like, that was open. They could have gone for it, and they were on the right track, too. And it looks
GoogleFrog, like... GoogleFrog just narrowly managed to save his constructor down to the southwest. It did get
narrowly
up
being the operative word. I think the decloak range may still be large enough.
Oh, boy. Say, though. Just 10 HP.
Yeah, the decloak range is just, I think... barely large enough.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, there that's dead. One more shot and down.
Brave Constructor.
Nothing over to the northeast, though.
All Drone.
Yeah.
Rocco's coming in now. You know, I'm not too sure how they're going to do against the Slashers.
I guess the Slashers, they should be fine. It's everything else, the Scorchers, I'm worried about.
Hmm. I don't know. I just feel like they're so fragile that
that's a fair point, yeah.
But I
really
don't know.
They do have a ranged disadvantage.
Yeah.
A pretty significant one, too. 450 to 600. Yeah, that's a bit of a problem. I mean, Slashers are almost twice as expensive, but still...
Oh.
No, 1.5 times the cost.
Scorcher coming in. Two of them. Gonna clean up the rockets, maybe? Ooh.
It's hard. Scorchers have a hard time dodging the rockets. Like, vehicles have a hard time dodging rockets. So, rockets, I find, tend to be fairly useful against them.
Slashers are chewing up the rockets pretty nicely.
Yeah... But they did take the commander.
Commander.
Why is the
here.
Commander moving in here? The commander's a riot commander. You don't have the range.
It's too much. Charging skirmishers. Silly commander.
Yeah, but Glaive's coming in at least. That will work.
Much better idea.
And GoogleFrog, wow, they're getting really behind compared to Drone. Mostly thanks to Reclaim. But yeah, Drone, they just don't really have a whole lot that's open.
Drone has definitely hit that critical mass of Slashers now.
Yeah, nothing really short of, I guess... Napalm runs would probably dislodge them, or Thunderbird runs.
Those Glaives try to run up into the group, but they barely made it in there before they got chewed up.
Yeah.
Drone's making good use of these Slashers, too. He's pushing them right as far as GoogleFrog's going to let him, it looks like.
Well, there are sides coming in now. GoogleFrog does have a position they can deal with.
Excellent, excellent.
But the commander is starting to go down. There's nothing the GoogleFrog can do about this. The commander... No, wait. Is there?
Oh.
Wow. 26, but is there... No, there isn't. That Lotus, they got to be careful about. The 1 second left.
Oh, the Lotus, though. Oh,
the Lotus will take the kill.
No, this Lotus is going to take him out. Oh, no.
Lack of attention right at that crucial point. And that just buries GoogleFrog even deeper in the hole. And they throw in the towels. So GoogleFrog goes down to losers. And Drone continues after a very promising opening.
Wow.
That is unfortunate.
Man, that was a good game, though.
Yeah, but like I said, it was kind of down to that first combat. And who was able to get through.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, it almost decided the game, essentially. I mean, after Drone was able to pick up all of those glaives... Right, he had the raider advantage that let him put out all the slashers, snowballed the slashers, and that was really all there was to it.
Okay, so that was
very well done.
Yeah. So at this point in the bracket, Steel Blue has beaten Exploit. Felthos and Snugglebase are going at it. I don't know how far along they are at this point, so I'll have to check. But that's also best of one, and then we'll get on to losers pre-finals. The Steel Blue and Felthos, or Snugglebase, whoever wins between that match. It's actually a fairly even match. Whoever wins between that is... So yeah, Felthos and Snugglebase have been going on for 4 minutes on Hide and Seek.